Halten! Halt meine alten Treuen! Mit Aule, Fettmänner! Sieg heil!
They're born?
Yes.
March 8, 1918.
What town?
Racine, Wisconsin.
Oh.
I lived there all my life.
What did you enjoy during your childhood?
Well, my childhood. I just like to play games with all the kids, you know, whatever.
And play outside in the
just
cold Wisconsin weather.
Sheep, my good sheep run, some of you probably never heard of them. Get old hands and try to break through the hands of the other
guy. Did you join the army?
I did join.
You didn't join?
They sent me an invitation.
you are cordially invited too.
Well, the war was only on in 3 months, and
that's
I
would you.
Send a letter okay. to report.
I'll meet you in there. I've got the door propped open for you.
To Fort Sheridan, Illinois, which is only about 40 miles from Racine. Before the war broke off, the government had a CMTC camp, which is for kids in high school to get off the street during the summer.
The Allied forces faced the Allied powers in both Pacific and European theaters. For America, this meant war on two fronts. By mid-1940s, Hitler Germany had seized most of the European and had their eyes set on Britain and Russia. The war was rapidly becoming more intense. Interventions from Britain and the U.S. became critical.
Well, then they sent me to St. Louis, but it was over Christmas, and so there wasn't much going on. There were 36,000 around the country on the same program, and 80,000 to be engineer, radio man, technicians, you know, college people. They sent me to, I went to Louisiana for about 4 weeks or so, but they didn't have enough men for a division. So they sent me to Camp Howie in Texas to fill the division. And of course I had some stripes, so I was extra man on the end of it. Well, the first battle we were going to have was across an open field, but we were stationed in the edge of a wood. I talked to one of the other sergeants. Hey, look over there. Guy over there. Takes his first aid kit, lays it out. He's killed. Boom! Shoots right through his foot.
Oh, God.
He was scared of going to battle, but he was crazy enough to. Now, I don't know what happened to him, but if he had been reported what he did, he'd go to jail for at least 15, 20 years.
Joe's experience in the military were much like the other soldiers during World War. Difficult to forget.
We're fighting the Vosges Mountains. Now, in France, they start at the Mediterranean, and they get smaller and smaller as you go way into the city. Now you think of France like the United States. Well, France is just a little bit bigger than the state of Wisconsin. So you can walk or drive across it in one day like an hour, you know. The officer in charge said, well, it says patrol out and see where, you know, find the Germans, because they know they stopped ahead of us somewhere. It was about 7:30, 8:15 in the morning. We started down. There were two older sergeants that had been there longer than me. And they were walking up in front and I was in the back and scared them whole hands if you didn't separate them. So I'm separating them, so when our children, our martyr comes in, so we killed 6 men, maybe 1 or 2. And so we walked down, we got about a little less, maybe 100 yards from that woods ahead of us. And all of a sudden, they opened up with 2 machine guns. And then it stopped the meat. And then I turned around and hit the ground and looking for something to shoot at. But before I could even find anything, couldn't find them. They're kind of in the woods. And before I could even find anything, I was laying there. And it was pretty one short burst, so close to my chin that I dirt in my face. Every man in that group was killed. At 4 o'clock, they blew the whistle. 150 men ran across that field. One man got in that wood, and there was a print that was in him. So there were 150 men, like it took a long time. Just went after them. Germans started laying artillery on us. And the first one was about 100 feet in front of us. The second one was closer. The third one went right behind me. Well, hit one of my men in the back. He thought he was wounded. So he said, "Oh, I'm wounded. So I crawled over to where he was. And just as I got there talking to him, like, "Woof, we're roof, roof, roof." You know, the shell's coming because they shoot it like this. And you hear the sound before the bullet gets there. If I hadn't moved over to help that guy, I would have been this close to the shell. The way it was, it lifted me off the ground, tore all the muscles out of the leg. First thing I asked the guy, "Have I got a little hager?"
Der Tag hat begonnen. Im Morgengrauen tauchen aus der Kim in der Sehnebucht die Massen der angloamerikanischen Invasionsflotte auf. Mit einer Fernkamera hat der Kriegsberichter unmittelbar vor Einsetzen des gegenseitigen Artilleriebeschusses diese Aufnahmen gemacht. Kleinere Landungsfahrzeuge übernehmen von den Transportern Truppen Abwehr aus allen Rohren.
This is a solemn but glorious hour. I wish that Franklin D. Roosevelt had lived to see this day, that the forces of Germany have surrendered to the United Nations.
Spent about 4 or 5 months in the hospital over there. I came back on a Queen Mary. I was halfway across when they announced Roosevelt died. And then I went from hospital to hospital. I was in the hospital 9 months. And the war was over for the last 4 or 5 months.
The wildest celebration of them all was in New York's Times Square. Never before or since has there been a crowd like this on the Great White Way. 2 million people screamed their elation at the end of the most devastating war in recorded history. For 24 hours, the celebration went on, and not for a minute did it lag. Victory had come. Old Glory waved over a happy land.
The victory won in the West must now be won in the East. the whole world must be cleansed of the evil from which half the world has been free.
The devastation you see here was caused by the explosion of the bomb above this zero point. Only the strongest buildings are left standing, and they are gutted. Looking north from zero point, this is what was left. Looking east, the camera records a scene of complete devastation in the immediate area. To the south, these are the ruins. Looking west from zero point, the same complete leveling is evident, the same inability of structures to withstand atomic power.
Shadows fill an empty heart as love is fading for all the things that we are not saying. Can we see beyond the scars and make it to the dawn? Change the colors of the sky and open up to